there, this is Ashlyn with Bellevue Avenue.
Today we are going to talk about how to apply the painterly overlays. The first thing you're going to do is open up an image that you would like to apply the overlay to. Once your image is open, you will go to File, Place, then navigate to your Painterly Overlays folders where you will choose an overlay. We have a variety of overlays to choose from that you can also blend together, including watercolor overlays, a watercolor paper overlay, chunky paint, subtle paint, and two canvas overlays. For this first image, I'm going to choose the subtle overlay number 11, then click Place. Once the overlay is sized to fit the image, I'm going to go up here and click the check mark to place it. The best blend modes for the painterly overlays are either overlay or soft light. For this image, I'm going to choose the overlay blend mode. Now, I actually really like how it looks as it is and would be happy not doing anything else to it. Here's the before and after. However, depending on the image's exposure, I may want to lighten or darken the overlay a bit. One way to do that would be to add a levels layer and placing it as a clipping mask over your overlay by clicking Ctrl-Alt-G so that it only affects the paint layer. Then you would adjust the levels layer to lighten or darken the overlay. Another option that you have with the levels layer is to add toning to your overlay. We've designed the overlays to have no color tones in order to give you the most freedom regarding the application of the overlay and not change the color tones of your image. But if you want to add toning, you can use this levels layer. Simply play around with the tones in the various red, green, and blue channels to get your desired tone. What I'm doing is adding a bit of blue to the shadows and red to the midtones and highlights. Here is a before and after of the toning. Now I'm going to show you an example of how to apply the watercolor overlays. Again, to choose an overlay, I'm going to go to File, Place, and navigate to the folder with the watercolor overlays. First, I'm going to choose the watercolor paper overlay, then click Place. Click the check mark to place. Change the blend mode to overlay, then lower the opacity to around 55%. Now I'm going to add the paint layer, so I go back to File, Place, and I'm going to choose watercolor number 1, then click Place and check. Again, I'm going to change the blend mode to overlay. Here is a before and after. If you would like to brush off some of the texture from your subject, what you can do is add a layer mask. To add a layer mask, you will click on the layer mask icon here. You will then choose a soft brush. The hardness is set to 0. I'm going to set the opacity to 100% for this time because I just want to brush it all off. Make sure you have black selected, then paint on the layer mask over the areas that you do not want the paint effect. Here is the before and after. Okay, now we're going to look at another image. Again, I'm going to go to File and Place, then navigate through my folders, and I'm going to choose Chunky Paint number 1. Now I could choose overlay for the blend mode again to give it a stronger paint effect, but I'd like to go a little more subtle in this image, so I'm going to choose soft light instead. Next, I'm going to brush off some of the texture from the main floral portion. So I'm going to add a layer mask, and using a soft black brush, I'll simply brush the texture off. Now I'm loving the texture on the right, but would like to add a little more depth on the left. So what I'm going to do is duplicate the overlay layer, then add an inverted layer mask after deleting the current layer mask. To add an inverted layer mask, click Alt plus the layer mask icon. Next, I'm going to choose my brush again, but select white rather than black and paint over the areas that I would like a bit more texture. So here's a before and after. As you can see, it gives a touch more of texture. And here's the full before and after. Thanks so much for joining us for this video, and I hope you enjoyed learning about how to apply the painterly overlays to your images. Also, feel free to add any suggestions or requests in the comment section regarding future tutorials that you'd like to see. Thanks again, and we'll see you soon.